Hey guys, how's it going?
Hey, Derek, how you doing?
How are you, sir?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
you,
too.
Hi, Mitzi. Nice
to meet you. You guys have been flipping for 13 years, and it hasn't been going very smooth, right? So you must be a glutton for pain.
Absolutely.
So I love the fact that you're still fighting to stay in the business, but what has been keeping you in the business?
Well, the flexibility.
We have four kids. When he was working his 9-to-5 or 9-to-9 job,
I was working 12-hour shifts. I was always gone. No, I was a deputy for LA County. As a cop, I completely missed my kids growing up. I was never around. I was always at work.
And we were worried about him because it is a very dangerous profession. We don't want him to have to go back to that. Flipping has given us so many opportunities for our family to have a better life.
We've had good years and we've had bad years. When some years are bad, that I'm just like, I sit dormant for months because I'm thinking, I don't want to do this again. But then
the savings starts
running low. So I got to get back to work. I got to put my chin up and get back out there.
I mean, are you guys kind of at the make or break point on this house?
Yes.
I would say, yeah.
So if we don't make money on this, you're probably gonna have to get a job.
Yeah.
Okay, you don't want to do that, right?
Absolutely not. Flipping is in my blood. I love hands-on. I do pretty much all the work in the house.
So that is, like, in my opinion, the worst idea in the world. The most important part about flipping houses is finding houses. So say, I'm not a contractor, I'm an investor. Come on, give it to me.
I'm not a contractor, I'm an investor.
Okay, great, and that's the mindset we need, because instead of spending your time doing labor, spend your time finding real estate.
I should be taking notes.
Another thing that's happening to us is we'll put the house on the market, but when they come with their appraisals, they always slam us with the appraisals.
We had a property in Lakewood just recently. We were in contract for like 638, and it appraised at like 617.
Oof.
Yeah.
Buyers can't get a loan for more than what the appraisal says it's worth. So coming in low means that Alex and Mitzi could be forced to drop their asking price or lose the deal completely. I'm guessing that they're over-improving their properties, but I won't know for sure until I hear their plans.
Okay, well, we better make some money.
Let's go look at this thing.
That's the hope. So it's 3-bedroom, 2-bath.
And how many square feet?
1753.
And you guys paid?
403.
How much are we planning on spending to fix it up?
We're thinking around 50.
And what do you think it's gonna resell at?
550.
And you're doing it on your own, you're planning on doing the work, there's no general contractor, so how long do you think the project is gonna take?
I'm gonna say six to eight weeks.
That's very ambitious.
We could do it.
I think I could do it.
All right, let's show me around.
So this is bedroom one.
See, the original floors are here.
Yeah, these are the original. We're hoping that it flows throughout the living room. Now this is gonna be a good conversation.
Oh yeah, this thing where we're gonna argue. I'm gonna keep all this and just reglaze it all to white.
That's ridiculous. We have to gut it all, maybe save the bathtub.
Budget.
How much do you think it's gonna cost you to gut this bathroom?
I'd say about 4 to 5.
I'd gut it.
I would gut it, yeah.
So bedroom two is right here.
Once again, sand the floors down.
Pop in brand new laminate. You save time and save money and it'll look brand new.
Really?
Yeah.
Wood floors are like a gold mine. When we find wood floors, it's like, wow.
If you sand the floors, prep the floors, restain the floors, let the floors cure, you're gonna take a lot more time and money than if you just pop in laminate.
But even if it's in here too?
So we'll just play it out, see how it goes.
About that.
We'll see what's under the old laminate, see if we still have wood under there.
All right, sounds good.
Bedroom number three.
We wanna close this door up.
Because this goes into the kitchen.
I agree with that, actually. What are your plans in here?
So I wanna close this diner window, make it back to drywall. We're gonna tear this wall down.
Are you doing the layouts or are you guys hiring an architect?
We're doing layouts.
You're doing layouts?
Yes.
Okay, are you guys using any like online software or some tools to help you do that?
No.
No, we're not.
You've done a lot of construction. Is this load-bearing?
It's absolutely load-bearing.
And you know how to do that work?
I hire someone to do that.
Okay. Good. Yeah.
I have my two kids. They come in. I'm just kidding.
Okay. Good.
I would like to put an island, but she wants to put a peninsula and put the refrigerator over there. I go, no, I don't want the refrigerator over there. I want the refrigerator to stay where it's at.
When you're walking into this room, it's just like, it's in the way. So I was thinking we could just tuck it into the corner. And then have a peninsula.
You can't tuck a refrigerator in anywhere. The refrigerator is huge.
If you guys are spending all that money to open up this wall,
yeah.
The last thing we want to do is block the view with a fridge. When you come through the front door, you'll actually be able to see all the way back into the house.
Okay. Exactly what I've been trying to tell her.
So I think the fridge stays right here. We open this up, we close this off, we do uppers, lowers, maybe white shaker cabinets, some new countertops, really nice backsplash. I think you'll have a nice kitchen. Okay, so this has to be an addition, right?
Yes.
Please tell me you verified the permit.
Yes, yes, it's permitted.
I mean, it's a big space. It's a big, ugly space.
You don't like it?
I would like to relocate the water heater outside. get rid of the bar.
What do you think about this fireplace?
I say we just paint it.
I want to get rid of it. It's just hideous.
So you want to rip it out and rebuild it?
I would love to do that. It looks dated, and if I get rid of it, it's going to look nice and fresh.
You're going to spend $10,000 to redo this fireplace. You are never going to get that money back.
Exactly.
You said one of your problems was the houses aren't appraising.
Now he's using our words against us.
Yes, I am. Because you're spending too much money. You're making them too nice.
Fair enough.
I'd paint the bricks, restain the wood, do something right here with the hearth, new laminate in here. So, backyard. So this is nice. Is this a garage?
Yes,
it's a drive-through garage.
But I didn't see a driveway. So where's the driveway?
Follow me.
Being able to pull through the garage so you can park extra cars back there could be a bonus to a buyer. But the missing driveway has me a little worried.
So this goes out.
Is this a bathroom?
Yes. That's the second bathroom.
Is it permitted?
Yes, it is.
What are your plans in here?
Gutting it completely. $2,500.
$3,000.
Okay, that's cheap. Okay.
And then this is the garage door that you saw from out there.
This goes outside to the backyard.
So what is this one then?
This is the problem.
Why is it a problem?
This is our access from the street.
Yeah. You guys are in a parking lot?
Yes.
Laundromat.
Okay, so this isn't good news.
No.
This is a first for me. Honestly, I'm not even sure they should have bought this house. There is a chance because the market is so hot and the inventory is so low that the attached commercial property doesn't affect the sale. But it's a pretty big problem to ignore.
If you have three interested buyers and two of those three buyers hate the location, you're down to one buyer.
Yes.
And the more demand, the higher the price. The higher the price, the more the profit. I mean, that's gonna hurt your value.
Well, because of the bonus room, we have a little workshop back here.
Oh, this is neat.
We figured this would compensate for the lack of driveway.
All right, so this is actually a huge win for you guys. This is a ton of value. I wouldn't say it's a wash between this and the parking lot, but I think this helps bring up the value. All right, so you think it's about $50,000 to fix up the house, right?
Yes.
403 plus 50 puts us at 453. How much is the loan and what is the monthly payment?
We actually don't have a loan. We have an investor. They're putting up all the money. We're putting up all the work and the risk, because of course it's in our name. But we're putting in our savings for the fix-up costs.
And then how are you dividing the profit?
It's just 50-50.
How much are your closing costs and selling costs when you go to sell the house?
Probably around 19.
So let's just call it 20,000?
Yeah.
So if our break-even is 473,000, you guys sell for 550, we have a profit of 77,000. You have to give away half to your investor, so you guys will make $38,500, which is great.
That's great. That's if it's only
50,000, and that's if we can sell for 550. But I wanna run a test, and I wanna run the numbers based on you guys getting a loan for 403 and getting a 12% interest rate.
Okay.
So at the end of the project, we're gonna see how much we're giving to investors and how much we're spending to get the loan. And whichever one is greater, we know that's not the good one.
All right. Smart.
Hey, okay.
I like that.
All right, let's do that.
Alex and Mitzi have a lot of potential, but they need to stop doing the physical work and focus on the bigger issues like loans, appraisals, and finding houses. If I can get them to think of this as a long-term business instead of a single flip, it can make a huge difference.
All right, first. You got it?
Ready.
We gotta find out what's under this laminate.
Oh, it's paper.
Yes.
Oh, so look at the old floor was stained super dark.
So it's probably dark all the way.
I'm gonna say drop laminate.
I think if you at least try to sand a little piece, a tiny spot, just to try it out. If it's too difficult, then we'll just lay laminate.
All right, because if the entire house is that dark, that's gonna be a ton of work.
Gotcha. So I really want to save these hardwood floors. I know you want laminate, but let's at least test it out.
Good luck.
Look at that. Absolutely beautiful.
I still think laminate will be faster and cheaper. Laminate's gonna cost us like $1,500, $1,600. Sanding them down, it's gonna cost like $2,600.
Think about the molding. If you do laminate, you're gonna have to remove all this molding in every single room. Save the molding, just paint what's there and just sand it. It's perfect. 80 years this has been here.
All right, let's go with the sanding the floors and redoing them.
You always get in your way.
I like the yellow.
Well, I want the blue.
Did you guys paint the house and not tell me? Hey, Tarek, how you doing? Are you? It looks good. It looks good.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Hi.
How are you?
This is my daughter, Skylar.
Skylar, nice to meet you.
She's the one that does all the designing for us and the colors. So.
Did you paint the house?
I didn't paint. I just chose the colors.
Okay, so your dad, he likes to paint the house, mow the lawn, take out the trash, do the dishes.
So I'm hands-on.
He's too hands-on. Did you guys paint the block wall too?
Yes,
we had the wall paint both sides.
You painted the other side?
Yes.
I'm not saying this is for sure, but this kind of looks like a blank canvas for some graffiti.
You want to tag it while we're at it?
I should put my name right here. Tarek was here. But I love the exterior paint. I like the light gray. I like the medium tone fireplace.
And we plan to do color on the door.
What color?
I want a yellow, but they're leaning towards a blue. My family likes to give me a hard time, but I think the more colors and patterns, the better. I like to say I have a little bit of Martha Stewart in me.
Ooh, that's a pretty blue. I think I'm leaning towards a blue, Dad. Try the other one. This one's a little too bright. Yeah, that's a no. That's too much.
No. Try this yellow. You didn't give this one a chance.
He's really pushing for that yellow.
Jeez.
You gonna serve cheeseburgers and fries out the window?
This one's more subtle.
Okay, but that's not, it's not popping. All right, I guess I'll go with you guys.
Okay, so we all vote blue.
Yes.
Unfortunately, yes.
All right, so we're gonna paint the door blue, and we're gonna hope nothing happens to the wall.
Yeah.
Right?
Sure.
Yes.
All right.
Ooh, my Compton flippers. What's up, guys?
We are
kind of at a standstill. Because we're waiting on the
city's approval still for this beam.
You've been waiting on the city for weeks already, right?
Yes.
They said everything looked good for the beam, but now they want like an architect to do the entire house, like details.
Window sizes, door sizes, until they give them the green light. They can't do nothing. I'm sorry, I think I should have kept that wall up.
Could I go backwards?
Just put that wall back up and just move on.
I mean, you could, but you've already wasted a few weeks and you're almost there.
So it's like quitting before the finish line.
The only thing you can do at this point is
work on things you're allowed to work on. So I don't want you to stop working.
Just pivot, move away from the beam and start working on other areas
of the house because we can't lose time.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, everything else is getting done.
To make sure that everything is ready to go the second permits are approved, today I'm meeting everyone at the tile store to get things ordered. Their daughter, Skylar, is the designer. But based on his love of yellow paint, I'm pretty sure that Alex will have some colorful options of his own.
We have a lot of material here. So you guys want to start with the kitchen or the bathroom?
Kitchen.
Kitchen. All right. So what are you guys thinking?
I like this for the back of the island.
Okay.
Okay, and then I like either one of these for the backsplash. This would have been my countertops.
You want to put this on the backside of the island?
Yes.
So when you walk in, you'd be walking into that tile. Okay, so I really like that.
So what I chose was this for the back of the island.
Okay.
This for the backsplash, and then this for the countertop.
Okay, so I absolutely love this countertop. Super clean, I like the lining, looks really good. And when it comes to the backsplash, 100%, I like this one. It looks super expensive, and it's not. It's porcelain that looks like marble.
Yeah.
So we're gonna get a high-end look for a low-cost price. Mm-hmm. So now we just gotta mix and match and put them together and design a house. I really like this tile, and I really like this tile.
Mm-hmm.
So my favorite combination, it's close, Alex. This one and this one is close, but I'm going with this one.
Oh, yes.
I think so it has pretty. A pop of color, nice pattern. So kitchen countertop, backside of island, backsplash.
Yes.
Okay, what about bathroom?
So I had chosen this one for the floor or this one for the floor.
I chose these two, Tarek, for the floors, but I'm leaning towards this one more.
I love this one, but there's no way this is in budget. This is a real cement tile, hand-painted.
I didn't even look at the price, I just like the color.
How much is yours, Skylar?
Like $250 a square foot.
This is probably up to $20 a piece. Oh,
$250 it is.
Oh, look, he sold himself. You see how fast he changed?
Let's go, I'll go put that back.
This is the tile you've been flipping with for 13 years. That's where all your profit's been going, right there. But when it comes down to these two, you know, let's just go with this one. If you guys are going with the wood vanity, I think it'll look good. Because it's a little bit darker.
Good idea.
All right. Very good.
All right, let's order.
The beam is up already, John?
Sorry about that.
Snooze, you lose.
We were waiting for the city to actually give us permission to start putting the beam up. And I guess yesterday afternoon, late afternoon, they gave them the green light. They got here around 6:30 this morning. So by the time I got here, the beam was up. I didn't even get to see it happen. Very nice, guys. That looks great. They got my wall. How long did it last? What, a month? I got some paint, extra paint. I'll paint it up before the open house. Tarek was right. They're gonna get me eventually.
You guys got this job done so fast. I mean, you guys knocked out this entire house in less than 10 weeks.
Yeah, about 10. Yeah, 10 weeks.
Originally, when we met, the rehab budget was $50,000.
We went slightly over. We're at $75,000.
Okay, why do you think you jumped up to $75,000?
This beam, we went way over budget on this beam.
We took your advice on hiring more people. So we hired, like, painters, and we hired a professional stager.
So what was it like hiring someone else to do the work that you normally do?
I loved it, because I'm actually spending more time looking for our next deal, which is what we've learned the most from you.
If you want to, like, make some real money here, which I think you guys can, we got to do more deals.
Yes, we do.
When you guys bought the house, you paid $403,000. Yes. And you guys are splitting the profit with a partner. So there was zero holding costs, zero carrying costs, 50-50 down the middle.
Yes.
Total closing costs and commission, they're about $26,000. So your break even here is going to be $504,000. That's pretty dang good, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So now I have to ask, what do you guys want to list for?
Well, we've been talking about it, and we want to shoot for the stars. So we're thinking 575?
Higher than what the appraiser said.
I found a comp north of us that sold for 565, and it was just like a basic flip, like no design.
But because we share a parking lot with the commercial business next door and we don't have a driveway, maybe we do sell it for 575 and the bank's appraiser comes in and says the most we're gonna give a loan for this house is 560, then the buyer has to come up with $15,000 cash on top of the down payment just to buy the house.
But the market has changed quite a bit. So I'm thinking with the buyers coming in, they're gonna waive the appraisal.
Okay, because the market is so hot and the interest rates are so low, you know, I think you guys can list at 574.9.
All right, nice. I like that.
So you're on board with
us. So the good news is that's a $71,000 profit, $35,500 for you guys, $35,500 for your investor.
Yes. The
investor's gonna be happy.
And I also ran it as if you guys got a hard money loan, because you remember at the beginning we wanted to see what was better, to work with a partner or to work with a hard money lender. So let's give it 1% to get the loan, so call it $4,000. Let's call it a 12% interest rate. So 5 months at $4,000 a month is $20,000 in carrying costs. So the hard money loan cost is $24,000.
Yeah.
The investor cost is $35,500. So in this exact scenario, you would have made an additional $10,000+. It's over 30% more return in your pocket. Is it something you think you'll consider next time?
Absolutely.
Okay, so when are we taking photos and when are we listing the house?
We're taking photos this evening.
And I'm listing it tomorrow.
Okay, you guys want to do open house Saturday?
Yeah.
Now let's just get this thing sold.
Yes.
All right, looks like we have some buyers coming in. Are you guys ready?
Yes,
let's do it.
Exciting.
All right, let's hope this hard work pays off.
It's super bright.
It is.
I love this fireplace.
Well, I would say you're having a good response for your first group.
I like the way they put the tile here, but I don't know if you could put anything on this because it kind of slants a little bit.
Character.
Character, that's what we'll call it.
Is hardwood floors okay with you?
Yes, very nice.
I'm glad someone had the brains to keep this wood floor.
They actually came out great. So in one of my upcoming houses, I might keep the original wood floors.
Oh, nice.
It's not something I normally do.
I'm loving the island.
Wow.
I've always wanted an island.
Yeah, this is nice.
I love the tile. I like that it's going this way.
Yes.
Instead of horizontal.
Ah, see? That's where the designing comes in.
Oh, I like it.
It's spacious.
Mm-hmm.
I love the window.
Yeah, the window right there
it's
over.
Perfect.
You guys better cross your fingers. They're about to walk into that bathroom.
I like the floors.
Yes.
I like the floors.
But because the tile is so white, I think the floor is kind of
to give it an
brings
accent.
That out just a little bit.
I do like it. It's pretty clean. It's pretty white.
All right.
It came out great, and we saved money.
Whoa.
Oh, wow.
Okay. So I didn't expect this.
Game changer.
Totally.
Oh, she loves the house.
I'm gonna get an offer.
Oh, another bathroom.
A garage.
There it is.
And shower.
It's nice.
Oh, this is nice. Yeah. It's like this house just keeps going.
Yeah.
It is surprising, yeah. You know, it is surprising to find it.
You can make this into like a little mini bar area, put in a little refrigerator and a little counter.
Yeah.
What do you guys think? You think they're gonna open that garage door?
They're gonna open it. They're gonna see a laundromat and they're gonna fall in love.
They're gonna fall in love. Well, we're about to find out.
That's very weird to me. It went from, this is a game changer to this is a game changer in the other way.
Yeah, I don't think we found your buyers.
Yeah.
So they are listing the house at $575.
A lot of living space.
Mm-hmm. I love that there's wood floor throughout the whole house. Everything seems to flow and there's a lot of natural light because of the windows.
Definitely.
I'm not so sure about parking. I mean, we're sharing the parking lot with the laundromat right there.
Right.
But overall, I really, really like this house.
I think they might put an offer.
I've worked with a lot of rookie flippers and you two have some real potential. You have the foundation to build a successful business, a business that you can pass down to your children. And I'm talking about a business that makes a ton of money. You know, construction, you guys move super fast. The one thing you're missing, more leads. So instead of painting houses and laying flooring, I want you to find deals.
We so appreciate everything you've done for us, everything you've taught us, and we plan to use that going forward.
The second we get an offer, you can give me a phone call.
Yes, absolutely.
I believe in you guys, and you can do this.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much.
A few days later, Alex and Mitzi accepted an offer for $590,000. And since they learned their lesson about overimproving, the house appraised at full price, making their share of profit $43,000. These two have a ton of potential, and I couldn't be prouder to announce their official graduation from Flipping 101.